So yeah, welcome back to my channel again on the auto service repair. Yeah, so what we have here today is the automatic transmission for Freelander. This is the one here. So the problem for this particular car is the there is no reverse on it, but all the shifting from first to fourth is intact. So we just pulled the transmission, and when we strip apart the transmission, so this is what we found here. So the direct clutch was worn out due to the brake band was snapped. So every time that the brake band servo is engaging, so since the brake band was snapped, this is what happened here. He dragged and scraped the metal of the outside part of the direct clutch. So this is Jf506E automatic transmission made by Jatco. Yeah, so the old brake band is here. So this brake band is seated is seated in here, and the servo is always, and the servo is pushing this rod over here. Yeah, that's how it is there. And yeah, so once the servo actuate, it push here and grip this one so that you can have a reverse, because yeah, there is a one-way clutch over here. So when this one grips, it turns and it spins on the reverse direction. And then yeah, we have to replace this, of course, the brake band and the direct clutch drum. So we already have all the parts over here. That's the new brake band. This is the reverse piston. Yeah, because this one is common for this particular gearbox, so we already bought
to pulling the float before we put in.
Yeah, the master
yep.
Already done.
Oh, okay, yeah.
We go bigger?
Yeah, can your uncle go pick it up?
Yep.
Yeah.
Cool. Okay. So, yeah, we already installed the low and reverse clutch frictions. The friction plate. Okay. So yeah, you should put and soak it on the ATF before you install the friction plate.
Uncle? You're struggling, huh?
Yeah, so we finished the top-port clutch already, and then afterward we need to check the clearance for the clutch pack. So we are now installing the low clutch housing piston. So yeah, and after that we put the low clutch piston and plate. This is the official tools on how to replace to press the low clutch piston. Yeah, and put this snap ring in. So yeah, this the wave plate. Yeah. Make sure that you have to put it on the wave is facing out, facing upward. So if you put it on facing downward, the friction plate, the steel plate will gonna be warped. So just put it, the cone is facing upward. We are installing the friction plate. Now we will gonna check the clutch pack clearance for the low clutch and the minimum clutch travel for this one is 1.1, maximum is 1.3. So we're gonna check if this one is good or else we gonna adjust the retaining plate. Yeah.
Is that Uncle Alvarez's wife calling you before? When, something about your mom?
No.
Ah, because Uncle, Jojo said Uncle Alvarez and Luisa, Ariel, right?
Ariel.
And Luisa asking to...
Wait, for good day?
October
10th. Ah, okay. Ah, maybe birthday. So...
It's all good, yeah? You can park it outside. So we got a good clearance over here, so it's 1.1, it's a minimum one, so it's good. Now we have to check the clearance for the low and reverse. This one here we need to check after this clearance. You
Yep.
You got the old battery here, yeah?
Old battery?
The old battery for the Captiva?
Yep.
Is it there?
Yeah, it's there. You want to put it back in?
No. I'll, in case the customer want it, I can give it to you.
Okay.